Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Kerbal Space Program of Death. I mean, of Jeff. Where previously we have done a lot of things, and this time we're going to do nothing. And I'll explain that briefly. First off, I want to say, this is version 0.17. There is a new version out, 0.17.1. However, that version includes mostly bug fixes that do not apply to me, and some UI improvements, which are okay, but I'm not really willing to upgrade right now. I'm going to wait for the next version, 0.18, which they've been showing on streams and has some really cool features. I'm not going to go ahead and divulge anything because you never know what's really going to make it through. But it looks really awesome, and I'm totally excited about playing it, but we're going to take a break until that comes out, at which point we will continue on with your regularly scheduled advancement of the Kerbal Space Program. There's a few reasons for that. One of them being that right now, where we sit in the space program is we are at a juncture, if you will. We have completely filled Kerbin with space crap. It's completely covered from head to toe with space crap. We've also covered the moon with space crap, and we've also covered Minmus with space crap. We've done everything that you could really do in this area right here in this version of the game around our own little planet. And so the next logical step would be to go to the nearest planet. We've still got debris flying around from the Maximum Veggie rocket and the Min rocket, whatever. And the fuck you, Shanzor. seriously, fuck you, Shanzor. But the next logical step would be to go to someplace like Eve, which is, you know, looking at this, it's the closest planet to us. Although that's not really a factor, because when you transfer out of here, you end up on a transfer orbit. So it's not like you want to fly straight this way while the planet is close. Although that does seem kind of reasonable, you know, if you could get yourself... You'd have to exit Kerbin going really fast, and then you'd have to spend a lot of fuel slowing yourself down to nothing so that the sun would suck you into it, but, and then how would you figure out when to do that? No. There are ways to calculate transfers to these planets without using mods. In fact, there's a website that I'll show you next time when I, in the next video when we do, probably in the next video when we do start looking towards interplanetary travel, but that's not gonna be what happens right now. For a number of reasons, one of them being that the transfer orbit prediction, you know, when I do my shot to the moon, you can see when it intersects the moon's gravity field and pulls me in. Well, in this version, unless you edit a text file and do some weird shit, it'll only show you one. So I can't see if I'm going to leave here, go into the sun's influence, and then hit Eve. Even if I was, like, you know, even if it was perfect, I wouldn't know it because it only shows you one transit. So anyway, that's my reasoning for that. So what are we going to do in the meantime? What haven't we done? What we're going to do is we're going to build some crazy shit. This is the experimental aircraft design phase. It's been a while since we've played around with space planes or any kind of planes. And I have some cool ideas for some planes that I would like to make. So I think we're going to go ahead and do that. Because part of the fun of Kerbal Space Program is advancement, and the other part of it is fucking around with crazy shits. So we're gonna be fucking around with crazy shits with me! My first idea! We will be using a actual command pod for this, because this is not gonna be a aircraft-type aircraft. It's gonna be a bit weird. It's gonna be sort of a, hopefully sort of a VTOL type of an aircraft. We'll see. But that's the idea. Not all of it, though. There's a little bit more to it than that. I'm definitely going to put a parachute on this because it's not going to end well. Let's just put it that way. Okay, so what I want to do now is... you know what? This isn't the best place to do this, actually. Why don't we go ahead and leave here? And we'll go ahead and go over to the rocket thingy. Because I need 4 levels of symmetry on this. And I'm not going to get that. You can only do 2 levels of symmetry in the space plane hangar. Which is, you know, that's fine. Whatever, man. You know. Whatever, man. I'm going to lay out the basic design for this. And then I'm going to head off and flesh it out. But what I want here are 4 beams going like this. And what we will do with these is create a... special kind of wing structure on here. What we're going to make is something that I've seen before in kite form, and that is a box craft. If I can figure out... There we go. I've accidentally made a swastika. That was not what I wanted. Damn it. Oh, shit. I think I'm going to have to do this asymmetrically, because what we need is a bit weird. We're going to need it to be like this. This may not even be the right piece. In fact, it's not the right piece for this. We should be using this. And never mind, we can't use this. You motherfucker. Alright, whatever. We're going to make this work. Damn it. Alright, so... Nope. There we go. That's not what I wanted. That's not exactly what I wanted either. That's getting warmer. Damn it. We just got warm. Okay. There we go. Now we just have to do that around the rest of it as a wing structure, and then see what we can do from there to try to make a box wing. Alright, so what we have here is the Boxcraft 1. I've put some control surfaces on it. This looks so dumb. Also, while building this, I thought of a better way to do it. Possibly, but I can't help but see what will happen if I launch this. Sildy's already screaming. No. No. This is not right. You cannot do this to me. This is not fair. That didn't work. Oh, I know what happened. We want to do that later. There we go. So it's really mostly just a one-stage thing. I just want to see if these control... Because it has four wings and four control surfaces, technically. I know the technicalities are not necessarily useful. Okay, it's got a bit of a spin to it. Oh, those wings! Oh, that's not good. Or maybe it is... No, that's definitely not good. Maybe if it swings fast enough, the wings will, like, flap out and extend gloriously into a... It'll unfurl itself. Unfurl. Look at that. It's like expanding and contracting. It's a goddamn space vulva. Holy shit, it is crushing, Sidley. I think it might be time for us to... What the crap? Okay, it's totally uncontrollable and absolutely insane, and goodbye. Let's see if this parachute works. Oh god, we got a lot of shit to jettison. Oh no, it's not gonna work, because it's gonna break off when the... No, it didn't. Yay, you get to live! That's a shock that the person piloting the Boxcraft 1 lived. Okay, so that's completely useless. We could try to space tape it together just for science. Now it's not flapping, but it's also... rotating uncontrollably. Yeah, the rotation would have to stop in order for this to be functional. But it's not horrible, you know? It's not completely exploding. I think that's just going to be a monument to the glory of experimental design. So I'm going to mock up Boxcraft 2. We'll save this one as Boxcraft 1, and then we'll make Boxcraft 2. Rip all this stuff off. And start again in a way that I think might be even better. Now this is a motherfucking box. That's what I'm talking about. That looks sweet. The other one looked stupid, but this one actually looks, you know, reasonable. And it has layers of symmetry. I basically expanded upon my accidental swastika design and extended it even further and completed it. So now we can actually add, like, external thrusters to this as well. So I think we'll use these lighter fuel tanks here. Or maybe we should put them... I'd rather have them on the corners, but I don't know if there's a way to do that. You know, sexfully. Successfully. Here we go. Inside. Alrighty. There we go. And we'll put, now that'll burn too fast. We'll use atmospheric jet thrusters. You motherfucker. I'm gonna put these over here just so I can slap this engine on. What? What the hoot? There we go. Alright, now we can symmetrify it. Bingo. And we'll put some SAS on it. That looks fucking sweet. I don't know how heavy this thing is or if it's going to be able to take off. I also actually kind of think in looking at this that we should maybe put some external landing struts on this thing. You know, for safety. This could be the most amazing thing ever created by anyone. I just want to point that out. Not, you know, I'm being modest here, as I always am. But, yeah, this definitely could be the most incredible thing in the history of the universe. In fact, it already is. This is what I love about experimental design, is the hopeful stage. The stage where it might work. You haven't completely devolved into, damn it, yet. Alright, so let's... Oh, I probably should have done stages. Yeah, I definitely should have done stages. But I kind of want to see if this will stand on the pad. It will. It stands. Now we have to find out if it will blend. Let's not fire... Uh-oh. It's not standing very well. We better hurry. I don't have time to think about this shit. Oh, yeah. Oh, look at us. Look! Look at us! It's controllable! It is actually control... Uh-oh. I'm getting some flappage here. I guess that's not actually that bad of a thing. I'm totally flying this thing. Okay, I'm getting some altitude loss issues here. But what I wonder is if I could turn this vertical and... Uh-oh, no. Uh-oh. Yeah, you need a lot of speed in order to get upward thrust. But if I cut the upward thrust now... Come on. Stop it. There we go. No. Now relax. Now we're going to try to land it like this. Oh, come on. Don't tell me that doesn't look fucking sweet. Those internal landing gear are not useful. We will need to put some space tape on this hog. I'm having a hard time seeing the ground because it's awfully late. And those engines make a whole lot of smoke. I think it might be better with some other kind of engine than the jet engine. Oh my goodness. If this works, man. Fucking spacecraft design prize, please. Oh no. Oh, what's up? The boxcraft! That is awesome! That is wicked fucking cool, man. It's functional, it works, it's flyable. You can't land it on its side, but you could take it off and land it vertically and then fly it like this. This is bitchin'. Like, wicked bitchin' right here. It's fully fucking functional. I don't know if it would be better to keep these wings floppy or attach them. Look, it's just sort of flying straight. This flies more stably than a normal aircraft does for me. This is wicked cool, man. This is what I'm talking about, man. Experimental craft design. It's bitchin'. Let's go back and buzz the fucking tower, man. Let's do some Maverick shit. Do some of that pilot shit, Mav. Uh-oh. Okay. Maybe it has a few... There is perhaps one or two technical... issues. It appeared to destabilize pretty dramatically when we were in a sharp turn, and I think that's related to space taping the wings together. No. Yes. Oops. Forgot about my symmetries. Did that work for you? Did that work for you? It did. The one other issue that we could have with this is the engines. They're not exactly in the right spot, for one. Oops. And for one other... Okay, that's better. For another, these engines are not making me happy, happy boy. I don't like them. I think we'll go with these smaller engines. I don't think we need anything dramatically... extra huge for this as far as thrust goes, and this would give us a nice light low drag engine that would give us, hopefully, the thrust required. These landing gear are not necessary because the external ones work fine. I'm thinking that just to reduce weight, we should go like that for now and use these external engines here as the landing thing. So we're going to make this the Boxcraft 3. And what else can we do to this? I'm sure that there's some other ways. Well, let's add a extra SAS module right here. RCS might not be a bad idea. In fact, it'd be a really good idea. But for some reason, I'm not going to do it. I almost think something like this would be a nice addition, but I don't want to mess with it too much. I like it. I quite like it. So let's give it another go. See if it's more stable with the space tape on. All right. I don't even know if it'll fly with the engines the way we have them. Oops, that's only on one engine. Oh, no. Uh-oh. Oh, that's not good. Although, actually, that does bring me to a point. I wonder if this thing... Oh, never mind. We can't jettison these wings. They're attached with non-jettisonable thingamajigs. That was just a stage issue. I didn't fire off these four externals at the same time as the other one, so there we go. And I didn't want to have too many detachable parts on this, because this is just a experimental doohickey. But yeah, this is pretty sweet so far. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, plenty of lift. Alright, so we've done away with the wobs. Wob, 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 wob. And I'm getting some pretty good changes in direction out of it. Although I'm not getting a lot of lift right now. Something has changed for the negatives! I'm gonna fiddle with this and see if I could find out where our lift control went. Alright, so it was two things. Now I've got good control over my lift and stuff. I can pull up, as it were. It was two things. One was the SAS unit was putting the center of gravity too far forward. It needs to be roughly flush with the wings, and it's not exactly like that right now. Uh-oh, my central engine just ran out of fuel, and these guys are about to run out of fuel. And that does not bode well for John Cott. Uh-oh. I think it might be time to go. Oh, hey! That would be a really good time to put a jettison-y thingy in there! Crap. So it doesn't have enough fuel right now, but I think if we add fuel this way, in the back, instead of in the front of it, I think that that would be a better solution. And these engine things, they're all just sort of test thingamajigs. I don't really know what we would, even if they, I don't even know if they're required. Might just be adding unnecessary weight to it, but let me play around with it a bit. Alright, I feel like this is pretty much going to be about as good as it can get for this one, because we have these lander modules here. But what I've learned is that the more you add down here, the better this thing performs at low altitude. Which is important, but if I add too much, then it won't be able to use the landing gear to land. Why is it off-center? That's a little odd. In fact, this is going to do some horrible stuff right now. Well, that wasn't so horrible. Either way, we've only got one engine now. Let's go ahead and... that's what I call buzzing the tower. Alright, so you can see now it's got really good mobility, turn rate, things like that, able to affect its course and trajectory a little bit. It does suffer from some lift issues, obviously, because... I don't know why that is. It's got four control surfaces. That's not bad, actually. The amount of lift we're getting is really not that bad at all. But the end result is that we have very little fuel. I mean, you have to have it on full throttle if you want to maintain your altitude. So I don't really know. I mean, we could put more engines on it. It's fully capable of supporting more engines. But this is just sort of the basic design right now of what we need the Boxcraft to look like. And I had another idea about using retro thrusters to try to land this thing upside down. But it would require some upside down landing gear, because it's much easier to land it like this because you don't have to spend all that fuel going up. But it would require retro thrusters, and in this case Billy Bob Broad is going to die because we don't have any. So it would be nice if you could have a craft like this that you could land right side down, right side up, or upside down. In fact, yes, the Boxcraft 4 now potentially capable of landing on its nose. I've put the landing gear inside here because it's too low if I put them down on the sides. And we've added 4 external downward pointing engines that will be upward pointing at the time that we decide to use them. However, this added weight has made this thruster a little bit inept. We could still sort of fly it. This is just for, you know, testing porpoises and stuff. Yeah, it still works. Still boxy. Still crafty. Uh-oh, it's turning over a little too soon. This is way too soon, in fact. Fire the retro thrusters! Fire the retro thrusters! Oh no! Not enough retro thrust! Okay, so we need more thrust than this thing is providing us. Well, this could get complicated because I think I might want to put engines on both sides of this fuel tanks. Well, this engine's simply not enough, and these fuel tanks probably aren't either. So we're going to add more weight, but in order to compensate for that extra weight, what we should do is add engines to both sides. Calm down. Calm the fuck down. What are you doing? There you go. That's ridiculous. And I like it. The issue then is turning these engines off. I wish there was a coupler that would allow for fuel to pass through. I don't think this will. Because when something has a fuel cross-feed capable, you know, it says so. And these most certainly do not. This one does, but that's not a decoupler. This is getting complicated. Well, what I could do is something like this. We'll take this guy again, and we're gonna make a coupler here, and then we'll take another one. Oh boy, that's too high up. But this is the basic idea that I'm operating on right now. I don't know if it's gonna let me do that. Come on, let me do it. It's for your own good. You like it. Okay, that's as low, or that's about as low as it'll go. And then if we take engines and go like this, now we can decouple, but the problem is the wrong one is attached. I need this one to be attached, not the other one. Damn it. Here we go. We'll just turn it upside down. Man, this is getting really confusing. Very fucking confusing. Okay, so theoretically, this engine will fire at the same time. These engines here will all fire at the same time. And then this will decouple. And then these ones will fire. I need to put those on their own stages. As a retro burn. And then everything will be perfect. This is ridiculous and I like it. I actually quite like it. Boxcraft 4. Sort of a universal flight craft. Whoa, let's not use all of our fuel here. Okay, yeah, flight characteristics much better this time. Able to do nice rolls and stuff. Maintain a level flight. Get a good banking turn without crashing. Oh yeah, this is doable. However, we are about to lose thrust in these guys here, so I'm going to use the last of their thrust to try to get me an upward trajectory. That's not going to happen. Let's do the jettisoning. Don't hit! Don't hit! Don't hit! Don't hit! Please don't hit! Please don't hit! Alright, let us please disable flow to that. And fire retro buster, thruster busters. Okay, that's working. Deploy every landing gear. Oh god, we're gonna land on a slope. Oh, my controls are fucking weird. Come on. Come on. Oh, it almost worked! No, let me go! Whoops. Oops. Well, it's extremely survivable. It's very difficult to explode this thing. Yeah, turn me over. Whoops, stop firing. Look at that! This thing can take a beating. Okay, so we didn't technically succeed, but largely that was because we were landing on a slope. I think this could work. I think that this could work, and I think it will work, actually, if we do it carefully. But that's a pretty impressive experimental design. An aircraft that can take off vertically, fly... Whoops. Oh, that didn't quite save us. Fly horizontally, and then land upside down or vertically. That's pretty impressive! Huh? It doesn't have any SAS, I don't know why I turned that on. Whoa, that's a close clip there, no wonder it did that before. Alright, so let's turn, actually this way, because it's nice and flat over here. And then we will coast for a bit. And just cruise. Alright, so once those are toast, then I can jettison them. Oh my. Then it really starts to tip over. Okay, so I think it might be time for me to disable this fuel flow and fire the next engines here. And then we can start doing the upside-downical descent. Deploy our gear. Okay, we had some engines hit. Nice and easy, nice and easy. Nice and easy. Mycenaean. Come on. Oh, what's up? That's staying there forever. Oh, that is bitchin' cool. I wish this cockpit... Oh, no, you can't see outside of it. I don't know how you'd get back into it if... Yeah. Hey, the cockpit actually... You sit in it upside down, so this is actually perfect. This is how you deal with the upside-down cockpit syndrome. The world's right side up now, the old Joffing. Hell yes. Okay, so we've made an aircraft that can take off vertically, fly horizontally for a little while, and land on its nose. Experimentation is awesome! Alright, so that was our experimental box craft, and for this one, what I want to do is make sort of like a C-130. A giganto-huge plane that uses very large fuel tanks. I've tried to use the large fuel tanks on space planes or winged planes before, and it never works. So let's make it work. I need a... Are you? That may be too soon. too soon. This is difficult because the wing parts in this are so small that... Yeah, I'm going to go ahead and mock something up here real quick and see if we can get an idea of what we need to work with. This is perhaps, by all accounts, the most ridiculous thing I've ever made, hence the name the KSS Hilarious. Here's our super tanker plane. I don't even know if these things function as wings. So, to make up for that, I added wings to the front of them. There's about a billion control surfaces on it, and it's some gigantic tail thing. Actually, you know what? Oopsie. Let's undo that. Give me that thing back. I have an idea. We don't need that. We don't need that. I think all we need is that. to put on something like this, but right side up. Oh, it won't do it. You bastard. It's like halfway intersecting it. Well, that's not good, but we can just use this and add a control surface to it. There's our rudder. That's really weird. Whatever. This isn't going to work anyway. Hopefully we won't need more than this one engine because it's gigantic. But I want to keep it very simple for now just to see if this thing's even capable of flight. With the floppy wing structure, as it were. Oh my goodness. I can actually flap the wings! That's incredible. That is incredible and also really dangerous because I actually broke the wings off. Holy shit! Holy shit! Okay, Elfrey. Look at that! He's like, yes! That was awesome! We were flapping the wings! That was cool. That was really cool. I like that I could flap the wings, and I think that might not even be a detriment to the aircraft that it is capable of doing that. As long as I don't break the wings off in flight like that. Alright, so this time, with a fresh Kerman, I'm going to trim the ailerons out so that hopefully it won't be so dangerous to attempt a liftoff. Let me get up plenty of speed first, obviously. Come on. Oh, man. Oh, look. It's trying. It's failing. Oh! Oh! Okay, the engine broke off, but look. That's so cool. That's so fucking cool. Oh my god. this has got to work. This will work. I'm going to make this motherfucker work. All right, so we fire off all these bitches, then we jettison these bitches, and then we flap our way around the world. The beauty and splendor of this thing. This beast. This gorgeous machine of flappitude. Let's go. Let's go. Upsie daisies. Upsie goesies. Oh, please run out of fuel, solid fuel tanks. You're going to rip my wings off if you don't. Please run out of fuel quickly. Please. Please. Yes. Yes, we're there, man. We're there. Oh, shit. It can work. I think it's just a matter of, flight testing it. In fact, I think I know what I should be doing a little bit better here. I should probably put these, or something like them, smaller versions of these, on the wingtips themselves. Come on, take me home. Lift me off. Oh, hey! Okay, that's not good, because they broke off. But, we're gonna go ahead and stop you guys from existing. I also want to move these further back. Because, that engine keeps snapping off. Not necessarily a good thing. And we don't want to put too much weight on these wings, because they're already tippy-downy enough. So we're gonna put... Come on. Like this. Watch how nice I'm gonna put it for you. Aha! Weren't expecting that one, were you? Bingo! Bird plane, go! Oh! Oh! Well, it worked for a minute. Okay, that didn't work. I have an idea. I have a good idea. Okay, that's not true, but I have an idea. Eh? Bet you didn't think of that one, did ya?
Mm-hmm.
Now we have the extra thrust, and my wings can't hit the ground and break off because they have independent landing gear that will be jettisoned upon. Oh, shit. Okay, maybe I spoke a little too soon. No! Fly anyway! Fly anyway! Fly anyway! Not that way, but fly anyway. Oh no, we've got one too many wing structures on that side. Fly away, fly away, fly away. Uh-oh. What's happening? Oh, we might have made an accidental submarine again. I'm sorry, Thunley. Man, we are losing a lot of Kerman in this experiment. Okay, I don't know what happened there. I'm going to try it again. Oh, it's pushing the wings forward. And I still don't know what's happening. One more time. Because I think I might know how to fix that in flight. Yeah. Oh, no. Just stay on the runway for a minute. Come on. Give me what I need. Just a little bit. Something broke. Just a little bit further. Come on. Come on. Up. 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 Shit. Okay, that's not gonna work. Well, what we could do is, yeah, this will work actually. I don't want to lose the flappy wing structure here, but if I attach these guys to the... No, that won't work. We'll have to move them closer to the main body of the plane. Like this. Is that backwards? No, it's not. Because we need this to be attached to this so that when we jettison it, it will not be supporting the wing structure anymore, because we don't want that to be attached to the plane. We want that to be floppy. We want that to be a flopped up. Alright, so this time, for sure. Okay, it's still... you know what? I never liked runways anyway. They are dumb, and I don't like them. Come on, up. Oh, fuck me! My control surfaces did not appear to be doing anything on this wing until I pressed down. I don't think this solid thingy is a great idea after all. Let me do some tests, see if I can get it in the air, because I want to really badly. Alright, so I have achieved flight, and I'll show you how I did it. However, I have learned something very important. That bird plane, not necessarily viable. It will fly, sort of, but, interestingly. So you have to start flapping your wings carefully until they start to bow upward. Then you can really crank on the down. And then here, you have to be really careful not to break your engine off, like that, and then bingo, up you go. Problem is that the control surfaces do nothing when they're all bent like that. But look how awesome! Look how freaking awesome that looks. Look how awesome. Come on. Awesome. I'm a hawk. I'm a space hawk. It's really, you know, it can spin like crazy too without breaking apart, which is pretty impressive. Come on, give me some forward juice momentums. Yeah! No! Fuck! Okay, so I like the idea of the flappy wing thing, but this is not going to work for point A to point B type stuff. I mean, as far as, like, awesome-looking shit, winner. But function, not so much. All right, so there was a couple of experimental aircraft with me, one of me, and for now we're going to be taking a little break from Kerbal Space Program, and when we come back, version 0.18 will be out, and we are going to go on and do incredible things with the new features in the new version, and with our own solar system, with me, one of me.